Ladies and gentlemen, next to me, legendary techno artist, producer and DJ Chris Liebing from Germany. So it's you only here actually to play one day, to play two shows on one day, and then you're here with your family, do a little holiday?
Yes, yes. I did it in a very, let's say, streamlined fashion.
Okay.
I'm here for 2 weeks to do a little holiday, Easter holiday, and it worked perfectly with a winter music conference. So we had our pool party and our nighttime party at Space until this morning, actually. This is why my voice might sound still a little fragile.
Let's talk about some music. For my feeling, you're a techno artist for ages now, and you had your own style and drove your own style. And your music is, we had a bunch of people, we were talking about sounds, a very sound, lead sound orientated music. But I have the feeling that your sound, the things that you play and that you release also on your label and that you produce are more about the certain kind of rhythm, certain kind of percussions of the rhythm, of the feeling. Yeah. Not so with this lead sound orientated music. Is that right?
Yeah. No, the attention and the focus is not really on one certain sound. Of course, sounds pop up and they're extremely important to give a certain groove, a characteristic, or something outstanding, something that you can grasp. But what I'm also trying to do is not only to have a continuous groove going or an interesting groove. It's all about the atmosphere that you create by having a groove as your base layer, basically. Mm-hmm. And then adding not necessarily like lead sounds. There is a lot of sounds, maybe more subtle in the background that build up a little bit over a period of time and go back down. And it's the way I'm mixing as well. It's just I'm trying to get a different kind of grooves going and have sounds coming in and out, but essentially it's about creating that atmosphere in the night, yeah. Next year I have my 20-year DJ anniversary when it comes to playing techno music.
Oh, okay.
So I have DJed already before, but not electronic music only. But it is essentially back then when I started to try to do this. Mm-hmm. I mean, already with vinyl, I was trying to do this in a certain way of mixing the vinyls. Mm-hmm. But of course, you were really limited. I always had in my head this idea that you continue a certain atmosphere that you created with that one piece of vinyl. Mm-hmm. But you wanted to continue it and maybe layer it with another new groove and have it fade out over a longer period of time. You know what I mean? Like long transitions.
Okay.
But that's a result out of the old Strictly Rhythm days, you know, wild pitch groove, like 13-minute tracks, DJ Pierre.
Yeah.
Awesome.
And you were mixing them for like 7 minutes. Mm. So you were like slowly EQing the one out and EQing the next one in. That's kind of the wild pitch thing.
Yeah.
To create this, not that you listen to one track after the other.
Yeah.
And as soon as the first loop samplers came out, there was like, I think, Red Sound, Psych Loops, you
mm-hmm.
remember that
yeah.
thing? That was my first tool that I had where just like you could sample a loop and then you could just continue run it,
okay.
put on the next record, mix it in and still have that other thing running. That was essentially the beginning. But then obviously when Tractor came out or was more usable for, or let's say, Final Scratch in the first first days was it was called, and then Tractor developed into like a loop based four deck thing, which I actually participated a little bit into developing that. Like,
okay.
We need four decks, we need this, that's the way it goes, and I'm really happy today. I actually feel like it's still in the beginning of these new times of technology.
Okay.
You know,
yeah.
There's so much new things now you can try out and you can work on and integrate into your setup to be able to create that what we've been talking about in the beginning.
What do you prefer when you work in the studio? Do you prefer like plug-in or analog machines, and what do you Do you prefer working out of the box, yeah, just with your laptop on, or do you use a bunch of machines?
You know, I'm not trying to be an extremist in any ways. Mm. There's a lot of people who say like, oh, I need to have a machine right in front of me. I think there's good things in all of these worlds, in the digital world and the analog world. So I've been always trying to combine the best out of all these worlds, you know. And sometimes, well, as you know, it's even more essential to have a total recall than to have that certain little characteristic beep somewhere, which is lost in space and time after you forget to record it or something. So, yes, essentially, if I work with analog stuff, and the good thing is in Frankfurt, the studio I have is basically a studio complex with a lot of friends, you know?
There's more studios. Mm-hmm.
It's like Monologue, Brianson, Haji, and others are basically in
very
one house.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, so we basically pass on some machines. Someone buys a new machine, and maybe you're tired of working with it, so the other one uses it in a different way. So essentially I'm using the hardware, I'm recording it into digital, and then you use these little bits and you work on these with plugins The main focus on that is not to lose any sound quality.
Yeah.
That's my main focus. Yeah. So even if you go digital, try to use the best sound cards, conversions, and tools that you have to keep that I don't know, human influence
that you
can get out of hardware a little bit better than out of software, I find, you know?
Yeah, great. That's a statement.
You know, to keep that. Yeah.
It's amazing to see when you talk to certain kind of people how they work and how they try to keep the spirit and do their own way of working. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, legendary, I must say, the ambassador for German high quality techno music, Mr. Chris Liebing. Take care, my man.
Thank you.
And we're gonna sip a little drink now.
Thank you.